We brought everyone here. You were the last to arrive.
I see. Thank you. We owe the Confederacy a great debt.
I have waited 25 years for this moment. You owe us naught.
It's Lord Hien!
Lord Hien!
It's him!
He lives! He lives!
Some few words of encouragement would not go amiss, my lord.
Right. Yes, of course. Right. Off I go. We are a sorry lot, are we not? Tired, dirty, stinking of blood and sweat and ash. The people pushed to the point of breaking. And yet, we won. The perseverance to endure decades of oppression. The will to carry on the legacy of those we have lost. These were the bonds that held us together and gave us the strength to reclaim our home. After 25 hard years, the shadow of the Empire no longer darkens these lands, and we may at last look forward to the dawning of a new day. But, my friends, it will be a day of work. So I ask you, have you yet the strength to stand? To rise up with me once more, here and now, and begin to rebuild our homeland?
This will not end with Doma. We will see to that, right, Lys?
Right.
Indeed, this is but the beginning. The tide is turning, and it shall soon bear us back across the seas, and onward unto the next battlefield.
Thank you. you are. All packed and ready to go?
To the best of my knowledge, yes. Apologies for the wait. The task of tying up loose ends invariably takes longer than one allows. Happily, however, all now seems to be in order.
Then there's nothing left to do but to board the ship. Do try and enjoy the journey, won't you? It may be your last chance to rest for a while.
That would depend on the good captain's choice of route.
As ever, Tataru, I pray you take all due precautions while making your inquiries. Better to avoid the local authorities altogether than risk a repeat of our Ishgardian episode.
And what sordid episode is this, pray tell?
Naught to speak of, I assure you.
You there! Hold that ship!
What are you two doing here? Shouldn't you be in Doma?
Shouldn't you? You left with nary a word. I half wondered if I had done something to offend.
Upon learning that you had departed for Kugane, we immediately resolved to give chase. Our comrades can manage affairs in our absence, and it seemed the least we could do.
You mean you came all this way just to say goodbye?
That too, aye. But there was something else I felt I had to say. You helped us win our freedom, and for that I cannot thank you enough. Accordingly, after we have established an interim government and so forth, I think it only meet that we repay the favor by dispatching our own forces to Eorzea. If you would have us.
We harbored no expectations of such generous aid, and as there is no telling when the Empire might strike back at you, would it not be wiser to concentrate your resources on the defense of Doma?
I had a mind to pursue a more aggressive defense, to which we will send forth shinobi to provinces far and wide to spread word of our victory, that we might inspire others to take up arms as we did. Even the Empire has its limits. If the Garleans cannot be certain where and when the next rebellion will take place, how can they commit another force to Doma? And besides, so long as this debt remains unpaid, how am I to face myself and Gorsetsa?
As you wish. I will relay your offer to the Eorzean Alliance.
All of Doma is counting on you to finish what we have started. You have it in you, Lys, to seize the future you want. Never forget.
I won't, Hien. Not your words or anything else. Everything that led us here, that will drive us forward, I'll carry it with me always. And that's a promise.
I will hold you to that. Go with them to Eorzea. Tell their people of our triumph and of our pledge to stand with them.
By your leave, I shall pave the way for our new alliance.
Hurry up, you lot! The ship's about to weigh anchor!
It seems our time is at an end. Go well, my friends. And may we meet again beneath a western sky.
I always knew that woman was unfit for command.
Aye, when you think of all the resources we've poured into that hole, and for what?
Beast yet lives. Mayhap it is time I sharpen my claws. I wonder, will you walk into my parlor once more?
For Dolorem Lupus, come at the command of the Lord Viceroy to present the prisoner taken by the Cranier Lupi. Xenosia Galvus, I presume. It's true what they say. You do have the eyes of a monster. A ravenous, insatiable fiend.
You, give the butcher your weapon.
Yes, my lord.
My lord, this is...
A reward given in recognition of your service. I trust it will prove more capable than its former owner.
I swear, I'll not disappoint you, my lord.
Good. Now... Silence that mewling little piglet. I would not hear another sound pass her lips. Until I strip the fat from her.
Pray, join me in welcoming our Scion allies, but recently returned from their mission to the Far East. We have been most eager to hear a first-hand account of your time there, eventful as we understand it was.
Very well. Allow me.
Such victories are rarely won without sacrifice, but the prize is worth the price. Doma, free after all these years.
Bloody hells. Flooding their own castle for a better chance at victory. We could learn a thing or two from that lad.
Our agents report a flurry of communications between Garlemald and Alamigo in recent days. Tis plain they are in the midst of deliberating their response to the Doman uprising.
Good. Every Imperial unit in occupied territory will be on the lookout for civil unrest. The fear of leaving critical locations undefended will make commanders think twice about committing their forces, giving us a chance to seize the initiative.
We have a chance, aye. Mayhap the last one we're ever going to get. While we've done our best to rebuild the resistance, the Imperials have only increased their efforts to root out sympathizers. If we keep on playing for smaller prizes, it's only a matter of time before they crush us again. And that we won't come back from.
A swift advance seems best for all concerned, not least poor Mistress Kryle.
Then let us waste no more time. The campaign for Alamegan liberation begins now. Our first objective will be to capture Castellum Valladina. Take the bridge, and the whole of the fringes will be ours. From there, we can push east towards the peaks. I name this operation Ralgar's Beacon. For as Ralgar once sent his star to guide our ancestors to these lands, so too shall it see us home.
It's begun then.
Good. It's the waiting that drives me mad. Standing around, knowing what's to come. I'll never get used to it.
Calm down, Nargo. You're making her nervous.
We've come this far, haven't we? We just need to make it the rest of the way.
Right.
Looks like the bastards went for the bait. The bridge is ours for the taking. Now remember, Minargo, I want you to make for the tower as soon as you see an opening and get that flag flying. We'll see to the fighting.
I won't let you down, sir.
Come then. Rolga's star shall burn bright this day.
Thank you.
friend! No more hiding! Let's finish this! Look! The flag!
Bridge is ours! El amigo! El amigo! El amigo! Yeah!
Stand your ground! It's not over yet! Damn it!
Let them go, Lys. We've done what we came here to do. That's enough for now.
Paladina has fallen? Impossible!
We have them on the run! Forward! No mercy!
Regroup! Regroup! We have to regroup! All units, fall back!
Commander, the 4th cohort has been routed. We'll be at the mercy of the enemy's reinforcements if we don't fall back now.
Idiot! We have the stronger force by far. Don't be taken in by their tricks. Or would you rather tell Xenos you lost to this rabble?
No, but if the snakes betray us in the confusion, we'll have no way out. I'm begging you, Commander. Give the order or we'll all die here.
As common traitors who drank of muddied waters, for all the good it did us.
Schools with me! The day is theirs, and so is this bastard bridge. Someone bring the snake.
Suppose. It's our first victory, isn't it? And that has to be worth something.
Thank you.
war. Ah, you've come. Welcome, friends, to my village. My home.
How fare your people?
Good, all things considered. Better than the Inanta, at any rate. They've sent an emissary. I'll take you to her.
We're here to help. Will you tell us what happened?
Aye. It began with a quarrel between the Imperials and the Kalyana.
The Kalyana are another Inanta tribe, the strongest and the most influential. Unlike the Vera, they want no part of our troubles. They swore fealty to the Empire and were content to remain within their borders.
Just so. The Kalyana forsook their pride and the fight and yielded to Garlemald long ago. But then a new commander was sent to hold the Black Bridge. She demanded the Kalyana surrender a hostage, this butcher.
For Dola. It doesn't make sense, though. The Vera are the ones working with the Resistance. Why would she threaten the Kalyana?
Because she is ignorant, like all Imperials. She knows not the difference between Kalyana and Vera, nor does she care to learn.
I see. All Fedola knew for sure was that the Resistance would come from the west. She reasoned, therefore, that if the Inanta on the east bank turned their coats, she would be trapped. I take it the Kalyana had no choice but to oblige her.
No, they did not. The Imperials left with the Kalyana broodmother's own daughter, Anamika. Long days and nights she looked out on the Black Bridge weeping for her child. Until you came. The broodmother knew at once which way the winds would blow. She and her warriors met with the fleeing Imperials in the road and demanded that her daughter be returned.
Bad idea. Fordola's not the kind to take threats lying down.
You know her well. The butcher turned her blade to Anamika and bade the Kalyana move aside. But the broodmother would not yield.
I know where this is going.
The Kalyana surrounded the Imperials, one of whom, whether out of fear or stupidity, cut the child down. There was naught that could be done.
What madness.
The true madness was yet to come. For in her despair, the Kalyana broodmother cried out for her daughter to be restored to life. She beseeched Sri Lakshmi's intercession.
She summoned a primal then and there?
That she did. If only for an instant. Bereft of courage and honor, the broodmother sought solace in her faith. The Imperials fled in terror at the sight of the goddess, abandoning these lands to the Inanta. Now the Kalyana bid us make pilgrimage to pay proper respects. Yet, though we Vera revere Sri Lakshmi as the holiest of the holy, we will not prostrate ourselves before her.
And so you turn to us?
Aye. All who have fought with the Resistance have heard tell of the warrior, the Icon Slayer.
I believe we have heard enough. Inconvenient though the timing may be, if a primal has indeed been summoned, we can scarce afford to ignore it. We must needs discuss how best to resolve this situation.
war.
sphere.
Why, mistress? Why does my Anamika slumber still?
Look thee on her face, supplicant. Thy prayer hath been answered. Flesh sundered hath been made whole. Blood spilt runneth through her veins. Breath stolen filleth her breast.
But she hears not her mother's words, nor sees her mother's face. She is silent and empty.
Only the vessel may be remade. Not so the flame which flickered within. Her soul hath been scattered to the four winds.
Now do you see her promises for what they are?
Alize, have you gone mad?
Mayhap I have, but I refuse to stand by and watch yet another tragedy unfold.
Who intrudes upon this sacred ground? Imperials, thirsting for blood!
No! We come not to shed blood, but to save you from the false god who would lead you astray. I understand how you feel. I do. You loved her with all your heart, but when the moment came, you still couldn't save her. The anguish, the anger, I know it only too well. But I also know where this path leads. To embrace a primal is to condemn yourself to an endless cycle of despair. You will never know peace.
A worm-eaten heart may find peace and serenity in service, in beauty and grace. This hath ever been my promise. Naught else.
You tempt them with visions of things that can never be and leave them bereft and wanting. No illusion, however sweet, can change the fact that your daughter is gone. Remember her as she was. Do not suffer this piteous shade to tarnish her memory.
For every prayer that Primal answers, it'll demand payment in kind. Do you have any idea how many more Ananta will die to feed its hunger for crystals?
They would have thee suffer man's spite and live in fear. Far better to dwell in my beauteous dream than endure so ugly a reality.
She's wrong! We hate the Empire as much as you, if you'd just listen!
Poor misguided children. I would spare you the torments of this cruel and misshapen world. Come, bask in my radiance. Let it fill your hearts and free you from your burdens. Abide in misery then, fools. The Ananta are more deserving of my blessing. Leave these lands and my dreamers be. I will not warn you a second time.
Thank you. Your weary souls in my bosom. To free you from your hate. Surrender to bliss. Do not your souls weigh heavy?
Defiler! Open your heart, you! Your weary souls in my bosom. To free you from your hate. Do not your souls weigh heavy? Your souls are stained.
free you from your hate! To bliss. Your souls are stained. Free you from your hate!
You did it again. You saved them. I just wish I could have been more help. So, it looks like the Ananta did have a mountain of crystals after all. Like every other tribe. gods are all such slaves to our weaknesses.
You slew our mistress! She was our hope, our salvation! Is there no end to your cruelty?
Listen to me, please. I know that you're only trying to protect yourselves because you feel frightened and alone. But that's how we all feel, don't you see? If we could just turn to each other for help instead of the gods, I'm sure we could find a way to live in peace. Your crystals are important to you, aren't they? Reflections of your souls, right? Well, you shouldn't have to sacrifice something so precious to a primal.
Who are you to question our choice? You who fight without fear? We wish only to live in peace. And if this be the price we must pay, then so be it!
I know there's nothing I can say to convince you. But I hope that one day you look back and see we only ever wanted the same thing.
Begone, damn you! Spare me your hollow words, and leave me to mourn.
I'll go. But it doesn't mean I'm giving up. Girabania is our home too. And one way or another, we're going to have to learn to live together. Come on. Alfino and Alize are waiting.
Ah, the savage returns, and with her tail firmly between her legs, beaten by beastmen, I hear.
It was a shameful display, by all accounts. She may have curried the Viceroy's favor with her bold promises, but in the end, she's just another plodding bungler like the rest of her kind.
Strange. You would think him a better judge of character. Then again, I hear she's not averse to a more physical mode of persuasion.
I thought she rose through the ranks rather quickly, but no longer. If only she had been content with her lot, she might have lived to see the morrow.
Fedolarem Lupus. Commander of the Crania Lupi, reporting as ordered.
Why do you tremble so? Could it be that the Empire's butcher is afraid? That she who walks with death is terrified of her own?
I'm terrified of dying, having achieved naught. Gladly would I give my life to win a great victory on the battlefield, had I but the strength.
Alas, you do not. Indeed, you are weak. And born of this weakness is a blind fervor, a raging inferno which threatens to consume not only you, but everyone around you.
Yes, my lord.
Thank you. You were defeated by the Resistance on several occasions. You misjudged the Ananta and spurred them into summoning an Icon. Have you anything to say?
I do not, my lord. My failures are my own. I am prepared to accept your judgment.
And that is very admirable. However, I've had enough of this dumb show. Give voice to that hunger I see in your eyes, or I will pluck them from your head.
I want... I want to make them pay! All of them! Everyone who ever mocked or looked down on me! I want the power to make them pay!
Very well. Then I shall give you a chance. A chance to transcend your mortal limits. Assuming, that is, you are prepared to wager your life for such power.
Transcend, my lord? I came here prepared to die. Tell me what I must do.
Thank you.
I remember how they laughed. Alliance and Resistance soldiers, eager for battle, trading jokes as we marched east towards the peaks. Beyond this last line of defenses lay the locks and the city. Breaching it would be no small feat. But we beat the Imperials back, just like that. And we liberated a village, the first of many.
Mm-hmm.